Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 6.2, Problem 8. This is Section 6.2, Problem number 8. It says, consider the experiment of flipping a coin 4 times. Part A says, make a probability distribution for the number of times it's possible to get heads in 4 flips. So a probability distribution, if you remember, is a chart with 2 columns. The first column lists every possible outcome of your experiment, and the second column lists the probabilities of those results in the first column. So for part A, we're going to have our chart with 2 columns. There'll be x for 1 column, p parentheses x, which you would read as probability of x for the second column. So if you flip a coin 4 times, you might not get heads at all. You might get head once, get heads twice, get heads 3 times, or get heads all 4 times. Now, to fill in these probabilities, you have 2 options. You could use the formula n combination x times p to the x power times 1 minus p to the n minus x power and fill in all those blank spaces, and that would work, but it would be sort of tedious. The other thing you could do is go to the binomial probability chart, find the part of the chart where n is 4, the values of x will go 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and for flipping a coin and getting heads, you want to be under the 0.50 column because there's a 50% chance for heads. And either way, you're going to get the same answers. For 0, the probability of 0 heads in 4 flips is 0.0625. I'm throwing in an extra decimal place than I usually use, and it's going to actually make things come out a little bit better. Usually adding decimal places makes things a little bit messier. For 1, whether you use the formula or the binomial chart from the book, you would have 0.2500 if you're looking it up in a chart that has 4 places after the decimal. It's really 0.25, but just to make everything nice and neat. For 2 heads, it would be 0.375. And again, if it's coming from a chart, it would have a 0. For 3, it would go back to 0.2500. And then for 4 heads all 4 times, it would be 0.0625. And notice it's symmetrical. If you look in the chart, anything under the 0.50 column will be symmetrical. It will steadily get up to a certain probability and then work its way back down with the same numbers. Anything under the 0.50 column is like that, just something to notice. So anyway, that's the answer for A. You have a probability distribution. The first column lists every possible answer you can get from the number of heads in 4 flips, and the second column lists the probabilities of any value in the first column. Now B says, draw the histogram. So again, for histogram, we're looking for essentially what looks like a bar graph. The bars have to be vertical, they have to touch. And we're just going to make a chart of this. I'm going to leave myself a little bit of room, because I'm going to want to come back next to that when I do part C, just to think ahead for a minute. So for my bar graph, the biggest probability I'm going to have to deal with is essentially 37.5% probability. So let's say we go 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40 will be enough. So I'll label the number scale going up the side, 0.05, 0.10, 0.15, 0.20, 0.25, 0.30, 0.35, 0.40. And where I can see my biggest probability is 0.37 something. 0.40 is, I can stop there. You can put in more if you want, but that's enough. So the first bar will go to a height of 0.0625. So I don't have 0.625 on my graph, but I'll go a little higher than 0.05. So the first bar, and again, it's got to be vertical. And by eye, that looks like it'd be about 0.06 something. And under that first bar, you put the value from the first column. So 0 goes right under the first bar. The next bar is going to go to 2500, which is 0.25, which I do have on my chart. It's going to go right to that height of 0.25. And the bars for histogram must touch. It must be vertical. So there's my bar that goes to a height of 0.25. The number from the first column is 1, so that's what goes under that bar. The next bar goes to 0.375. I don't have a 375 mark, but by I, it's exactly halfway between the 0.35 and the 0.40. So I'll go to the halfway point between 0.35 and 0.40. Again, the bar will be vertical. It will touch the previous bar. It'll be the same width as the other bars. The number from the first column, which is 2, will go under the center of the bar. And then the next one is going to go back down to height of 0.25. So same height, 0.25. And the number from the first column is 3. So right under the center of that bar, I put a 3. And the last bar goes to a height of 0.0625. It's a little higher than the 0.05. And it'll be symmetrical with that far left bar. The number under the bar will be the number from the first column, which is a 4. So there's the histogram. That's part B. Now C says find the mean of the probability distribution. So the mean, or some books call it expected value, what that is if you did this experiment of flipping a coin 4 times and counting how many heads you get, and you did that experiment millions of times and you took the average of those millions of results, what would the answer be? So you could flip a coin 4 times over millions of trials and divide out the results and find the average, and that would work. It'll give you the right answer. Or we can do it much less time. Is multiply every number in the first column times its probability, you'd get a few results, and you add them together. It'll give you the same exact answer. So the top row of my probability distribution, I'm going to do the number from the first column times its probability will be 0 times 0.0625, which is 0. Then the next row down, the number in the first column, 1 times its probability of 0.2500, which is 0.25. That's 0.25. From the next row down, the number in the first column is 2 times this probability of 0.375. I don't really need the 0 at the end. 2 times 0.375 is 0.75. Then the next row down, 3 times 0.2500, or really just 3 times 0.25, would be 0.75 again. And in the bottom row, the number from the first column is 4 times its probability, 0.0625, comes out to 0.25. And now I have 0 plus 0.25 plus 0.75 plus 0.75 plus 0.25. And if you add all those up, and you can use your calculator if you like, comes out to 2. I think of it in terms of money. I have 0 cents, 75 cents, plus 25 cents rather, plus 75 cents. There's a dollar, plus 75 cents again. There's $1.75, and then plus 25 cents. I have $2. So that's how I can add it up quickly without the calculator. Though the calculator would work very well. So the mean of the probability distribution is 2, exactly 2. That's why I put in the extra digit, because without the extra digit, it comes out to a decimal. The real answer really is 2. 2.0. So, D, find the variance of the probability distribution. So again, variance is a measure of how spread out the results of your experiment are from one trial to the next. So if every day you flip a coin 4 times, count how many heads you get. Is it always around 2, or does it spread out sometimes 0, 4, 3, 0, 4, or is it, you know, like 1 or 2 most of the time? So what we're going to do is set up a chart. The first column of the chart will be X. The next column is X minus the mean. The symbol for mean is the capital U from the Greek alphabet, mu. The next column after that will be X minus the mean in parentheses raised to the second power. And the last column will be the X minus mu in parentheses to the second power times the probability of X. And let's put some horizontal lines in my chart to keep things neat. So the column labeled X is simply the values of X that we have, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So X is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. That's the easiest column. So the next column, from every value of X, I'm going to subtract away the value of the mean, which for this problem was 2. So in the top row, X is 0, so I'll have 0 minus 2, which is negative 2. In the next column, X is 1, so X minus the mean is 1 minus 2, which is negative 1. The middle row of my chart, X is 2, so 2 minus the mean, which is also 2, 2 minus 2 will be 0. The next row down, I'll have x is 3 minus the mean is 2. 3 minus 2 is positive 1. And then in the very bottom row, x is 4 minus the mean, which is 2. 4 minus 2 is 2. So that takes care of the second column. The column after that, I'm going to take the answers that I got for x minus mu, and I'll raise them to the second power. So the previous column, the x minus mu result was negative 2, so I'll do negative 2 second power. Negative 2 times negative 2 will give me a positive 4. Remember, the negatives will cancel. The next row down, the x minus mu result was negative 1. So I'll do second power for that. Negative 1 second power, negative 1 times negative 1 is positive 1. The middle row, the x minus mu result was 0. So I will do 0 second power. 0 times 0 is, of course, 0. And then the next row after that, the result for x minus mu was positive 1. So I'll do positive 1 second power. Positive 1 times positive 1 is 1. And finally, in the bottom row, the result for x minus mu was 2, positive 2. So I'll do 2 second power. 2 times 2 gives me a 4. So now, one more column left to do. I'm going to do the result for x minus mu second power times the probabilities, which I have written down on the far left side of the problem here. So in the top row, the x minus mu second power result was 4, right from here, 4, times the probability of 0 heads. The probability of 0 heads, looking back to the original part of the question, was 0.0625. And 4 times 0.0625 is 0.25. So you can do as much of this on a calculator as you want to. I have a lot of tricks for decimals, and I can do a lot of them without the calculator, but using the calculator is absolutely fine. So the next row down from the previous column for x minus mu second power, I have a result of 1 times the probability in this row getting 1 heads once, would be 0.2500, really just 0.25. So 1 times 0.25 is 0.25, simple enough. And now the middle row, the x minus mu second power, as a result, I got 0, times the probability for the middle row. So for 2 heads, the probability was 0.3750, or just 0.375. You don't really need that 0 at the end. 0 times 0.375, of course, is 0. Things times 0 are nice and easy. The next row down, the result for x minus mu second power is 1. So for that first parenthesis, I have a 1. Then for the second parenthesis, the probability in that row for 3 heads is 0.2500, or again, just 0.25. So 1 times 0.25, that's easy enough, that's 0.25. And finally, in the bottom row, the x minus mu second power result is 4 times probability of x for the bottom row, probability of x in the bottom row, 0.0625. So 4 times 0.0625 is 0.25. And now for the variance, what I want to do is get a total of all those values in the last column. 0.25 plus 0.25 is 0.50, plus 0 is still 0.50, plus 0.25 is 0.75, and then 0.75 times plus 0.25 comes out to 1. 1.0, or just 1. So that's the variance. Find the variance of the probability distribution. The variance is 1. It's the total of that last column from that big chart that we filled out. And the standard deviation of the probability distribution is the square root of whatever the variance was. And fortunately for this one, the variance comes out to a very easy number to take the square root of. Typically for that square root, you need a calculator, you're going to get a lot of decimals, but this one just happens to be easy. Square root of 1 is 1, because 1 times 1 is 1.